Hi, I'm Dr. Anna Garrett, and welcome to my first video blog. Changing things up a little bit this week because I can actually talk faster than I can write, and it saves me time. And after doing a newsletter that's written for, I don't know, close to 10 years, I'm ready to try something different. So this is my first effort, and I hope you enjoy it. So today I want to talk about a topic that I feel like I should talk about every week. And the reason this came up again is because I was standing in my bathroom last week listening to the Rachel Ray Show while I was getting ready to start my day. And that's just something that I do. And so I listen out of the, you know, out of, in one ear, and I'm not usually paying a lot of attention to what's going on. But she had three women on there. And they might have been triplets, I don't know, I didn't catch the whole thing, but they were talking about women's health issues. And one of them began to talk about progesterone-only birth control pills. And of course, at that point, my head swivels around and I run in to look and see what this person is talking about, because I know that there are no progesterone-only birth control pills. And so that's what brings me to today's topic again. So what I want to talk about is the difference between progestin and progesterone. Those two things are not the same. Progesterone is a natural hormone that's made by your body every month when you ovulate, and it is calming, it's great for bone health, it's great for nerve health, it keeps you asleep at night, and just has a whole lot of other benefits that go along with it. Progestin, on the other hand, is synthetic, and this is a very similar molecule. It was tweaked a little bit so that drug companies could patent it and sell it as a medication. You can't patent a substance that naturally occurs in your body like progesterone. So what happened along the way is the medical community lumped progesterone into the progestin category and created all kinds of confusion. So the confusion that usually arises is, why does this progesterone product have a cancer warning on it? Well, because in California, it's lumped in with progestins, which have been associated with cancer. And so that warning is required on every hormone product. So here's the thing. Progestins are found in birth control pills. It is in the Mirena IUD. And so anytime you see a pill other than Prometrium, which is progesterone, it is likely to be synthetic. Because it's synthetic, it does do the job of uterine protection when combined with estrogen. So that's its most common use other than in birth control pills. But the problem is that it does not have all of the calming anti-anxiety benefits of progesterone. And so it's not like you're substituting one for the other. So if you're a woman in midlife, or you're in your late 30s and you're starting to notice things like more anxiety, or you're lying awake at night and when you were normally a good sleeper, or if you've got fatigue during the day, chances are your progesterone levels have fallen. And the best way to get those up, well, there's several ways to do it. If you're on the younger end of things, you can use a supplement called Vitex or Chaseberry to help with that balance of estrogen to progesterone, because that's really what the problem is they're out of balance with each other. Or you can actually buy progesterone cream over the counter and use that on your skin, and it absorbs into your body and helps replace what's missing. There's also oral progesterone. So I mentioned Prometrium, but compounding pharmacies also make progesterone capsules, and I personally take this because sleep is my personal midlife bit of hell. So I've been on progesterone for a long time, and it really helps. So if you're wondering what the difference is between the cream and the capsules, the cream is best for things other than sleep. The pills will help, but you don't need to go get a prescription to do that. The capsules, on the other hand, are metabolized in your liver to three different compounds, one of which makes you sleepy. And so that's how that works. So you need to take it orally so that breakdown process can happen so that you get the sleep benefits of it. So generally, I don't recommend starting any sort of hormone replacement unless you have had some levels done and you know that you need it. But it's pretty easy to identify progesterone deficiency, and it's pretty hard to hurt yourself with it. So if you're overdoing the progesterone, what you might notice is that you feel sleepy, or if you have issues with depression, those may worsen a bit. There are some providers out there that recommend huge doses of progesterone to overcome estrogen dominance. I've seen that work for people, and I think that's great. As a practitioner, that is not where I start, because I want to see how somebody is going to react to it, and I also want to make sure that their adrenal glands are working correctly so that we're not putting progesterone in only to have it go into the cortisol pathway and worsen situations of adrenal imbalance. So that's just my two cents worth on my approach to progesterone. So, to recap, progestin is not the same as progesterone. It does not give you all of the same wonderful benefits of progesterone, like calming and anti-anxiety. It doesn't help with nerve and bone health. Progestins are found in birth control pills and in the Mirena IUD. If you see it in a pill other than Prometrium or something you get from your compounding pharmacy, chances are it is synthetic. Those two things are not the same. One has been chemically altered so it can be patented and sold by pharmaceutical companies. Progesterone is a compound that your body naturally makes when you ovulate, and it cannot be patented. So I hope this clears up any confusion, and I look forward to sharing more video blogs with you, and I will see you next time. Thank you.